We continue now at the top of Daf Yud Zayin Amud Aleph and Maseches Moed Katan. This is Moed Katan, Daf 17a. The Gemara here continues the statement of Rav Huna. There were some other versions of exactly which Amora said this, but the statement is as follows. Talmud shenida lichvodo. If you have a Talmud that is ostracized, or that ostracizes someone else, rather, due to his honor, so niduyav nidoy, then that's considered a good nidoy. In other words, the case over here is there's something personal, and the Talmud is ostracizing, is putting someone in nidoy because of something personal between him and the other person. That is considered an effective nidoy. This was explained earlier. The idea over here is that the nidoy is not because of an avera that the person did to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. That would be a nidoy that would apply to everybody. Everyone would have to respect such a nidoy. But if it's personal, the point is then it's also going to be effective. It won't count towards the Talmud's Rebbe. The Talmud's Rebbe will not have to conduct himself as if this other person is in nidoy, but it will be effective for everybody else, as the Gemara here says. The Tanis we learned in the Braisa. Again, this was mentioned earlier as well in the previous daf. It says in the Braisa, menuda l'rav, menuda l'talmud. If somebody is menuda, is ostracized from the Rebbe, then automatically he's also menuda from the student. But menuda l'talmud, eino menuda l'rav. If somebody is ostracized from the student, he's not automatically ostracized from the Rebbe. And the Gemara infers, l'ravu de'eno menuda, he's not ostracized from the Rebbe, halakuli alma menuda, but from everybody else, the nidoy is a good nidoy. And the Gemara now explains, l'mai, what exactly is the reason for this nidoy? Iba mili d'shmai, if there's something that this individual did against HaKadosh Baruch Hu, so ein chachma v'ein tvuna v'ein etzel neged Hashem, there's nothing that can stand against HaKadosh Baruch Hu. In other words, the point is then everybody, even the Rebbe, would have to go along with the nidoy. Obviously, the case over here is the person is menuda l'talmud because of the kavod of the Talmud. And again, that works. The nidoy is effective. It just does not have to be followed by the Rebbe. It applies to everybody else, but not to the Talmud's Rebbe. He does not have to conduct himself towards this individual as if this individual is in nidoy. And the Gemara continues, Amar Rav Yosef. Rav Yosef says, Tzur b'mei Rabbanan, when it comes to a Talmud Chacham, Ovid dino l'nafshe, he's allowed to take the law into his own hands. But Mil said the psikole, if it's something that he is certain about. Rashi over here says, Avedino Lenafshe de Amarle at Mechayev Sali Hachi Vachi. He can say, you're chayev to me such and such. The psikole Shevadai Hulovelo Suffolk. The case over here is that it's something that is definite and not something that is a suffix, not something that is in doubt. And the Gemara continues, Ahut Surbame Rabbonan, if there's a particular Talmud Chacham, to have a sonu shomane. That let's say Rashi over here says, sonu shomane, Sheyodzin Olav Shemuos Ros. There's bad rumors about this individual. So the Gemara says, Amar Rav Yehuda, Rav Yehuda says, Hechi li'avid, what are we supposed to do in such a situation? L'shamdei, if we're going to ostracize this individual, Tzrichi le'rabbonin. So the Rabbonin need this individual. Rashi over here says, Tzrichi le'rabbonin de'asrei, meaning the Rabbonin of the area where he lives, to have a Rabbon. He's the Rebbe over here. So they need him. You can't ostracize. And lo l'shamdei, now if you're not going to do that, you're not going to ostracize him, isn't this going to be a chilul Hashem? So Amar Leila Rabbi Bar Bar Chana. So he said to Rabbi Bar Bar Chana, "Midi Shmi Aloch Baha. Did you hear anything about this issue? What do you do in such a situation? Again, of this Talmud Chacham, there's bad rumors around this Talmud Chacham. So Amar Le. So he said to him, "Hachi Amar Rabbi Yochanan. This is what Rabbi Yochanan says about this question. My dechsev. What does the pasuk mean when it says, "Kisif say koin yishmeru das v'torah yivakshu mipiyu"? The pasuk says, you should seek out Torah from this individual because he's a Malach Hashem. And therefore, the Gemara Darshans is a pasuk in Malachi. And therefore, the Gemara Darshans as follows. It means, im dome harav l'malach Hashem. If the Rebbe is similar to an angel of God, yivakshu Torah mipiv. Then you can seek Torah from his mouth. Vimlav, but if not, al yivakshu Torah mipiv. One should not seek Torah from his mouth in such a situation. In other words, it is true that you shouldn't learn from such an individual. The fact that the Rabbonah need this person because he teaches them doesn't make a difference. If there's rumors that he's not acting appropriately, they shouldn't be learning from him anyway. Rashi over here says, Vimlav al Yavakshu Torah, hol v'sanu shomane, since there are bad rumors about him, hadit srichi le Rabbonan lav klumhu. The fact that the Rabbonah need this individual, it doesn't matter. The mut of the lo yalfimine, it's actually better that they don't learn from him. The Gemara continues the story. Shamtei Rev Yehuda, in the end, Rev Yehuda did ostracize this particular Talmud Chacham because of the bad rumors that were around him. L'sof ichlish Rev Yehuda, and in the end, Rev Yehuda got sick. He was on his deathbed. Asu Rabbonin l'shiulei bei, so the rabbis came to visit him. V'yosa iu nami b'hadayu, and also this individual who was ostracized, he also came to visit Rev Yehuda. Karchazi Rev Yehuda chayech, when Rev Yehuda saw this Talmud Chacham, so Rev Yehuda smiled. So Amar Leh, so the Talmud Chacham said to Rav Yehuda, lo mistayech deshamtei lo gavra. It's not enough that you ostracize this individual, meaning myself. It's not enough that you ostracize me. El achuchei nami chayech bi, you're also laughing at me. So Amar Le, so he said to him, Lav bididoch mechayechna, I'm not laughing at you. Ela dechiazilna lu alma, what I'm smiling, the reason I'm smiling is because when I go to the world to come, so bidicho datoi dafilu legavra kevosich lo chanifile. My mind is settled because I know that I didn't flatter even a person at as high a level as you, even somebody as important as you. I didn't flatter you. Rather, I did what was right, and I put you in nidoy. And that's why Rabbi Yehuda was smiling. That's why he was content. Gemara continues, Nach nafshei de Rabbi Yehuda. Rabbi Yehuda died. Also levei midrasha. So then this individual came to the base medrash. Amar Lui said to them, Shruli, can you permit me? Can you take off this nidoy that Rabbi Yehuda placed upon me? Amru le Rabbonin, so the rabbi said to him, Gavra de Choshev k'Rav Yehuda, a person as important as Rav Yehuda, leka hacha de l'shreilach, there's no such person here that can permit you. Elazil legabe de Rav Yehuda nesia, go to Rav Yehuda nesia de l'shreilach, he'll be able to permit you. So azal lekame, so he went in front of Rav Yehuda nesia. Amru le Rabbi Ami, and Rav Yehuda nesia said to Rav Ami, poke ayin bedine, go check out the situation over here, see if he deserves that he should be released. Imi boy lemishrele, if it's possible that we can release him. Shari le, so then we will release him. So Ayin Rabami Bedine, so Rabami looked into the din, Savar Lemishrele, and he thought, yes, we could release, we could permit this individual. Amar Rav Shmuel Bar Nachmeni al Raglav, but then Rav Shmuel Bar Nachmeni, he stood up, Vyomer, and he said, Umashivcha shel beis Rebbe, if by the maidservant of the house of Rebbe, Lo noagu chachamim kalus rosh beniduya, the chachamim did not treat her nidoy lightly. When she put somebody in nidoy, they took it seriously, shalosh onim, for 3 years they took it seriously. Yehuda chaveireinu alachas kama v'kama. Certainly Yehuda our chaver, we should certainly take it seriously. In other words, we shouldn't permit it so quickly like this. We need to take some time. Amar Rabbi Zeira said, "Mai dekamon de'osa ha'idna ha'isabu bebe midrasha." What is it that all of a sudden this elder of Shmuel Bar Nachmeni, he shows up in our base medrash? Da'kamishani lo'asa, many years he hasn't shown up. Now all of a sudden he comes to tell us this message, not to release this individual. Shma mino lo miboy lemishrele. We say that we see from this, it's a sign that it is true, we're not really supposed to permit this individual. Lo sharele, so they didn't permit him. So nafik, so he went out, ki kabachi v'ozel, and when he was going out and he was crying, so asa zibur v'tarkei amose, so a wasp came and stung him on his private part. V'shachiv, and then he died. So ailula ma'arta, so then they brought him into the cave, the chasidi, where they bury the pious individuals, the chasidim, v'lo kiblu, and it would not accept, that area would not accept him for burial. Ailu lema'arta de dayoni. So then they brought him to the caves where they bury the dayonim, the judges, the kiblu, and they did accept him. My time, and what's the reason? Da'avid k'Rabbi Eloi. The reason why they accepted him was even though he sinned, but he followed the advice of Rabbi Eloi. The Tanya, because we learned in a brisa, Rabbi Eloi Omer, Rabbi Eloi says, Imroa adam sheyitzro misagaber olav. If a person sees that the Yetzer Hara is overcoming him, yeilech lamakom she'in makirno. So he should go to a place where they don't know him. V'yilbash shechorim, he should dress in black. V'yasatev shechorim, and wrap himself in black. He should do what his heart desires. He shouldn't do a public chil Hashem. In other words, he should do it in a way where people don't recognize him. At least it won't be a chil Hashem. That's what this particular individual did. So even though he did averus, but since he did it in this fashion, so he deserved to be buried among the dayonim. And the Gemara continues, Shivcha shel beis Rebbe Mahi. What was the story with the maidservant in the house of Rebbe where she ostracized someone? The story was as follows. The Amsa de Bei Rebbe, the maidservant in the house of Rebbe, Chazise lehu gavre, she saw a certain individual, Davim machi livno gadol. He was striking, he was hitting his adult son. So Amra, so she said, Lahave ahu gavre b'shamda, that individual should be ostracized. Dekavar mishum lefnei iver lo sitin michshol, because he's transgressing the Isra in the Torah of placing a stumbling block in front of the blind. The Tanya, we learned in a brisa, v'lefnei iver lo sita michshol. What does it mean that you shouldn't place a stumbling block in front of the blind? B'makel levno gadol hakasa medaber. The pasuk is talking about somebody who strikes his adult son. The idea over here is that it's a stumbling block because it's going to cause the adult son to become angry and strike back. And it's also for a son to strike his father. Therefore, it's basically a transgression of v'lefnei iver. And the Gemara continues, Reish Lakish have a minatir pardesa. Reish Lakish once was guarding a certain orchard. Asahu gavra v'ka'achel te'eni. There was a certain individual that came and started eating figs from the orchard. So Rama be'kala v'lo ashkech be. So Reish Lakish yelled at the individual. He paid no attention. He kept eating. Amar, he said, l'haveahu gavra b'shamta. This individual should be ostracized. Amar le, so the individual said back to him, Adarab, on the contrary, l'haveahu gavra b'shamta. This individual, you Reish Lakish, should be ostracized. Im mamo nischayavdi lach. Maybe I'm chayav to pay money to you. But nidoy minis chayavdi lachem, I chayav to be ostracized, I have to pay money, I shouldn't be chayav nidoy. So asa levei midrasha, so then Reish Lakish came to the base medrash to find out who was correct. So Amrulay, so they said to him, Shalo Nidoy Shalcha Eino Nidoy. His Nidoy is right. Your Nidoy is incorrect. That individual is correct to place you, to ostracize you, because you shouldn't have been so strict, but what you said was really incorrect. What's the way to fix the situation? They told him, they told Reish Lakish, you have to go find that individual and he'll permit you. So Reish Lakish said, Lo Yadanale, I don't know who he is, I can't find him. Amrulay, so they said to him, Zil Lagabe Nasiya, so go to the Nasi, the Lishri Lach, then he'll be able to permit you. The Tanya, as we learned in a Braisa, Nidu Veino Yodea, mi Nidu. Let's say a person was ostracized, but he doesn't even know the person who ostracized him. So Yelech Etzel Nasi Viatir Lo Niduyev. So he should go to the Nasi, and the Nasi will permit the Nidui. The Gemara continues, Amar Rav Huna says, Bi Usha Hiskinu, in Usha they instituted, Av Bezin Shasarach, if the head of a Bezin, if he sins, Ein Menadin Oso. So we don't ostracize him. El Omer Lo, rather, we say to him, He covered v'shei b'veisecha. You should go sit in your house privately, resign your position. We'll take a look at Rashi about the word he covered. In any case, the Gemara continues, chazar v'sarach, if he again sins, menadin osamim nechil Hashem. So then we do ostracize him because of the potential chil Hashem. And the Gemara says, u'pligad reish lakish. This argues on reish lakish. D'yomar reish lakish, because reish lakish says, talmid chacham shasarach, if a talmid chacham sins, ein menadin osam b'farhesia, we'd never put him in nidoy publicly. Shenamar, like the pasuk says, v'chashalta yom v'chashal gam novi imcha, Laila kiseyu kilaila. It talks about the Navi stumbling, and it says it should be like the night. You should cover it up. You should hide it. Don't do it publicly. You should cover up the nidoy just like the night is covered up. It's dark. And the Gemara continues, Marzutra chasida kimechayev tzurba merabon and shamta. Marzutra, the pious, when a Talmud Chacham was chayev to be ostracized, bereisha meshamis nafshe, vahadr meshamis lididei. First, he would put himself in excommunication. He would ostracize himself, and then he would ostracize that particular Torah scholar. That was a way of showing respect for this Talmud Chacham. Ki hava ayil b'ushbizeh, and then when he got home, so shari li lanafshe, he would permit himself, v'hadar shari li lididei, and then he would permit the nidoy that was on this particular Talmud Chacham. And the Gemara continues, Amar Rav Gidl Amar Rav. Rav Gidl says in the name of Rav, Talmud Chacham minada liatzmo u'mefer liatzmo. Talmud Chacham is able to put himself in nidoy and able to undo it as well. And the Gemara continues, Amar Rapapa says, Tesi li, I should get credit. Because I never ostracized a Talmud Chacham. Rather, when a Talmud Chacham was chayev to be ostracized, hey Chayavid, what did I do? I did like in the West, Mimnu Anegido did Sorba Meir Rabbanan. They would appoint a court to give lashes to the Talmud Chacham, velo Mimnu Ashamta. But they would not appoint a court to ostracize the individual. It was preferable to give the lashes. Gemara says, My Shamta, where does the word Shamta come from? Amar Rav, Rav says, Shem Misa or Sham Misa means there is death. It comes from the language of Misa, death. Well, Shmuel Amar and Shmuel says, Shemama Yiyah, it should be like desolation. It comes from that word, Shemama, meaning something that is desolate. U'mahanya bei ki tichya betanura. And the Gemara now says that when a person is ostracized, it is effective like the fat that is smeared on an oven. In other words, you'll never really get that fat completely off the oven. The same thing is true when a person's put in nidoy. Even when you take them out of nidoy, you'll never completely remove the stench of the nidoy from the individual. Upliga de Reish Lakish, but this argues with Reish Lakish. The Yom Reish Lakish, because Reish Lakish says, Kishem shenichneses b'masayim v'yarboim u'shmona evarim, just like it enters, just like the nidoy enters the 248 limbs of an individual, kach kishe yotza, so too when it exits the individual, yotza mimasayim v'yarboim u'shmona evarim, it exits all 248 limbs, meaning it completely disappears. There is no remnant that remains with the individual. Kishi nechneses tichsiv. How do we know when it enters? It goes into all the limbs. Tichsiv, because the pasuk says v'haysa ir cherem and cherem begematria masayim v'arboim u'shmona havi. Uses the word cherem to refer to the same idea, and the word cherem in gematria is 248. And kishi yotza tichsiv beroges rachim tizkor. When it exits, how do we know it fully exits? Because there's a pasuk that says that in the time of anger, you should remember your mercy. And what does it mean to say here, Rachim, Rachim, Bigamatria, Hachiavi? That's also the Gematria of Rachim, is 248, indicating that when the mercy is remembered, meaning when the person is permitted, so then there is Rachim, it leaves all 248 limbs. We'll take a look at Rashi over here. Again, it said, by the Av Bezin, we tell him to resign his position to go home, but we don't ostracize him at first. He covered, B'loshan azeh omrim lo. We tell him the following language. Asei atzmecha ka'adam shekovid olav rosho, v'shev b'veischa b'loshan kovid omrim lo. Make it as if you're not feeling well, you have a headache, go sit in your house. And that's a language of respect that we tell this to the person. Lishna Achrin, another way of understanding this is, he kavid his chabed kevodcha, shateshe beveischa, keep your respect, keep your honor by staying in your house. Kiseo means al tevazo so befarhesia. So kiseo means the idea that you should cover it up. You shouldn't do this to him publicly. Kelaila shechashecha, just like the night is dark. Vein adam roen, people don't see. Meshamis nafshe mishum yikare dahut sur midrabbonin. So he said that he would actually put himself, he would ostracize himself first before he would ostracize the individual. That was a way of showing respect to the individual. Mimnu anegida malchus, in other words, it was better to do malchus than it was to ostracize malchus. Yafel lem yoser misham tav hava malchile. They would prefer by the Talmud Chacham to give him malchus rather than to ostracize the individual. Umahani kitechi betanura. So he said again that it is effective and it stays with the person, like the fat that's smeared on an oven. Kishuman shatochen esatanur v'nivla besochu shein yotzei liolam. That fat never leaves. Kilomer makel choman de meshamtina le delo nafka minei liolam. Meaning that opinion is saying that when a person is ostracized, it is a wound that will never leave the person. Rish Lakish disagrees, and he says that that wound will in fact leave the person. And the Gemara continues. Amar Rav Yosef. Rav Yosef says, Shadi shamta gnufsa de kalba. If you throw a nidoy on the tail of a dog, meaning you ostracize the tail of a dog, so to speak, vi'i di do avde, it'll work on its own. It's going to be effective. And the Gemara has a story like this. Dahu kalba dava achel masani de rabbanan. There was a certain dog that was eating the shoes of the rabbanan. V'lo hava kayadi manu. They didn't know who was damaging these shoes. V'shamtulei. So then they pronounced the nidoy and whoever's doing it. So isli beinura begnufse. So then a fire got caught on the tail of the dog. V'achalte and consumed it. So you see that the shamta was effective. The Gemara continues with another story. Hahu alma dava kometzara leila hu tzurba mei rabbanan. There was a particularly strong individual who was causing pain to a certain Talmud Chacham. He was bothering a certain Talmud Chacham. Also, l'kami de Rav Yosef. So the Talmud Chacham came in front of Rav Yosef. He said, "What should I do?" Amar le zil shamte. So Rav Yosef said, "Go and ostracize him." Amar le. So he said, "Mistapina mina. I'm afraid of him." Amar le. So he said, "Shkili psicho alea." So he said, "Go write it, publicize it, write it down that you're ostracizing him. That's what you should do." So he said, "Kol shekein de mistapina mina. All the more so that I'm going to be afraid. If I do it so publicly, that puts me in an even worse position." So Amar le. So then Rav Yosef said to him, "Shakli achse b'chado. No, go and take it, write it down, but put it into a pitcher, into a jug," and we'll continue with this discussion in the next video on Daf Yud Zayin Amud Beis.